need her to hold that just for a second or two, because I don't want her to grab that. I'm going to flick it around again. But a great, great old-fashioned way of working a dog. As I say, you used to see or just the old ink. Just because that's blowing in the wind, that's really winding her up there. Because as I say, she wants to grab it, and you'll see now when I flick it up. Unlucky. Ha-ha. There you go. But hey, hold your fire there, boy. You can see she wants to grab that mark. There you go. So that was, what's your name? Copper. That was Copper, everybody. So I'll give you a bit of an idea there how that works. Now we've got to get on with this. They come from America, remember, the southern states of America. And it doesn't matter if this bird is hand-reared, hatched in an incubator, hatched how you like, they have a natural fear of dogs. So you've got to be careful how we do this bit. So what we do is, we would just get the dog out in the field, 20, 30 yards or 100 yards from the dog. Because no matter how much
time... ...and this ray with his Canadian Belgians, Phantom, Billy, Dirk and Tito. And in second place, we have Mr. David Curtis with his Phantom Grey here and his Freshers, Creon, stablemate Rob, Eros and Hector. And in third place, Mr. John Goodwin, with his family Dre here, and with his Shars, Sydney, Oscar, and Max. Moving out this time, we have 162, Jim, Tom and William. Jim, Tom and William.
No.
Thank you.
Moving out now for the showing is 168, Creon, Eros and Hector. Creon, Eros and Hector. And this time we have entry 142, which is Phantom, Billy, Dirk and Tito. Thank you.